Wix versus Elementor. I'm going to do a quick overview of my experience using both and who I think should use both. So I've used both. I've been using Elementor for quite a long time, for several years, to build most of my websites. And I have used Wix to help family members build a business website. And I'll explain to you in a second why that's important. So I made the mistake a little while ago of telling both my partner and my sister that each wanted to have to build websites for the first time ever. They both at the same time wanted to build websites, and they both asked me how to do it. And I've been doing it for like 15 years or something at this point. So I was like, oh, it's no problem. We're just going to set up WordPress and we'll get you hooked up with Elementor. It's no big deal. You just drag and drop it. Easy peasy. Man, was I wrong. They are both complete beginners. They've never built a website. They're not super techie people. And turns out that if you haven't been immersed in WordPress since its inception, like I have, then there's a lot easier things than just drag and drop. So just to get to that point, to understand how WordPress works, I think it's very easy, very simple. But to the average person who's not super techie, WordPress is not easy. And therefore, Elementor is not easy. So my biggest comparison is, if you are already familiar with WordPress, then Elementor is amazing. It's easy. It will kick up your ability to create amazing looking websites by yourself like 100 times. So if you're familiar with WordPress already, then Elementor's the way to go. There's so many extensions and plugins, and there's so much stuff that you can build on top of it. And even if you're not super techie, but you're still familiar with WordPress, then Elementor is going to make a lot of sense to you. And it might take a little bit of time to learn how to use it, but not much. And it's mostly just going to be drag and drop. And then you just have to learn a few of the quirks. Again, if you're familiar with WordPress, this is something you're familiar with in general, is just learning how different plugins work. However, if you don't even know what I was just talking about for the last few minutes, then I would go with Wix. Wix is actually really easy to use for non-techie people, for people who don't really care about how the website works, who don't plan on doing any sort of like back-end maintenance or anything. They just need a website up. So for my sister, she was setting up a website for her family's rental business, renting a cottage. And so I set up this website with WordPress, and I was like, yeah, super easy. Got them set up through Bluehost, and I bought a theme that like had all these like plugins and stuff for managing rentals. And I just thought it was great. But the first day they needed to change something, my sister called me and was very frustrated because she could not figure out how to use Elementor, how to use WordPress. And it was just a mess. And I felt so bad about it. You know, I felt so guilty because this was the best solution I had. So then I thought, you know, let me try Wix. I had never used it before. And I hear about it a lot. A lot of people use it. I wouldn't use it because I like to do a lot more customization and have a lot more control over my website. But for the average person, Wix is amazing. So I helped her set up the website on there. And within probably about 15 minutes, it all made sense to her. It was all very visual, very easy, just, you know, drag and drop without having to do any sort of back end coding, without having to understand how websites work at all. You just like drag a picture. Cool. It works. Drag, you know. So if you're not familiar with WordPress at all and you don't care about the back end stuff on your website, you don't want that tech stuff, I would go with Wix. It is working for like probably millions of people. And again, it's very visual. It's very easy to understand. And the only downside is, you know, to get real functionality, you have to sign up for their hosting, which, you know, is generally a little more expensive than you could get hosting for if you're going to do your own website on WordPress with Bluehost and stuff like that. But it's still not too expensive. And especially if you're running a business, then it totally makes sense to just go ahead and use Wix. And again, if you don't think you're going to do anything super complicated in the future, then you can go with all the features that Wix has built in. And that's going to work out really well for you. So again, this is what Elementor looks like. And you know, if you're not familiar with all this stuff already, then it's going to be overwhelming. Wix is going to be the way to go. And if you're familiar with running your own websites, even if you're not super techie, then I would go with Elementor. It allows you a lot more customization. You can install tons of custom made plugins. There's over like 5 million users of Elementor. So there's so many people making really cool plugins to do just about everything you want. Plus, just out of the box, it makes your ability to make your website beautiful in WordPress so much easier. So, and I would recommend too, if you're into WordPress, then I would check out Elementor Pro. There's an affiliate link in the description below if you're interested. It's got a lot more features, but the basic free Elementor is also awesome, and you can do, you know, almost everything you'd ever need to do just with the free version. So that's my breakdown of Wix versus Elementor and who I think each one is a good fit for. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any questions or comments, please drop them in the comment section below. And if you found it useful, please hit the like button and maybe subscribe. Finally, take a look at these videos that I linked here and check out the links in the description box below. I've put together some things that I think are particularly useful for what we covered in this video and for you in general. Some of them are affiliate links, so if you end up purchasing any products through them, I may receive a commission. Thank you so much for that support. It helps me to make more videos for you in the future. I hope you enjoy your Elementor journey.